And there, inside of that area, there is similar knot than this one. This is from other side, but this is like left side, and this is from right side area. And in this left side, like driver's side, this knot in inner is there. It is so tight, like in that one in here, that it is now, I estimate, that it is in there install and inside of that area within 1,000 newton meters force. And you might think that how I can measure and calculate that there is one knot in inside in here, that it is like 1,000 newton meters force in that area. Okay, and I have calculated that force so that I have torque reference tool what can measure about 200 newton meters force. And when I try to open that, this my torque reference broken totally, and there is this broken amount is about 400 newton meters estimate light, and it is huge force. And then when my torque reference was damaged and bad, I take my heavy duty this metallic socket wrench and bar, and using that device I broken and I damage my lifetime warranty sockets. And let's go to look at what sockets I mean. And there is really my socket size is 33 millimeters. It looks like that. And this fits in here. And then I need this bar what I can install in here and then bend this area. And then happens following situation. And I have in here this normal metal bar where is lifetime warranty, and look, this is like now propeller curve. This is like bended. This is not anymore okay tool because it has been bended so much when I try to open that inner nut. And then I took my heavy duty. I have this heavy duty tool in here what is also lifetime warranty. And look, this is almost 1 inch thick steel. And this last, but when I have to use this lifetime warranty, also this adapter, this breaks down. And let's go to look at how this is possible that my tools broke up. Okay, and there we can see this area, and next I install in here my those high quality lifetime warranty sockets, and we can see that how they broke up and how they damage. And firstly, I install this 33 millimeter socket in here, and then I install this my adapter because this my heavy duty bar, it is like 1 inch this size, and I have to install it in here in that way. And then when I start to move that, I have to install this my tool in just in here in that position. Good, now it's in position. And then I have to take in here, firstly I use my hands, but nothing happens. And I have to take a little bit longer bar. And now I firstly use these Home Depot hardware storage pipes, because using these pipes I can get, because now I can get about 200 newton meters force when I press that. Because this metallic bar, this length is almost 1.5 feet, it is like 50 centimeters, and then I install this my extra metallic pipes in here, in that way, and then I have force like 3 to 4 feet, like 1 meters, and now I have force in here about 400 newton meters. And let's look at what happens. Now I start to bend. Nothing happens yet. And now I think that I need even longer bar. And now I have again visited in Home Depot hardware store, and now I have really high quality steel bar. What this thickness is like 4 millimeters. That one, this is very thick and heavy. And this length is now 5 to 6 feet. And that means that it is about 170 centimeters long bar. Look, it starts in here and it ends in here. Next, I will use this tool and let's look at what happens next. Now I have in here force, what is about this 1000 newton meters force. And now we can see, there is this my long bar, look how long it is. It goes in here and in here. And now, my friend, you will see that what happens in there when there is force for this 1000 newton meters opening force. And I am trying to open that nut. And this is really world tightest and hardest bolt ever to open. And let's go to look at what happens to my tool. Hello and welcome, my friend. And next I am planning to show you that how to open 1000 newton meters force bolt and nut. And there is really bolt and nut what is really hard and difficult to open. It is extremely tight, hard to open, impossible almost to open. And next I will show you that how to open that bolt. And let's continue. Okay, and then this critical thing. Next I start to move this my long 6 feet bar in this down area in like in this direction, it goes in down, and I am trying to open this really hard 1000 newton meters nut. And now there can happen that this adapter, what is extremely high quality lifetime warranty adapter, this can be damaged and broke up and cut. And let's look at what happens next. And I start to bend that and look that area carefully. Okay, and then I start this job, and this is really, really interesting to look. Okay, and now we have even better view. And now I start to bend that and let's look at what happens. Okay. What happens? There is direct cut, and this my socket, what is in here, look, it snaps. And this is the force of 1000 newton meters. This my lifetime high quality socket adapter, it broke down. And this thickness is like this 1/2 inches, what is like 1.5 centimeters, that part. And now, I take my hammer and a little bit movement and saw this open, not yet. Almost. Okay, and now we can see this result. Broke part. Okay, and now we can look this cutting point, because there is this my part, and this part fits nicely in here. And really, 1000 newton meters force cuts this part in that way. And this is really lifetime warranty socket, and now I need to go to replace this socket in my this hardware store. But the thing is that there is so hard nut. Okay, and then when I need to open this world hardest nut, I need to now do some pre-work. And this pre-work is that I have to heat up this my nut using torch. And let's go to then take my torch, and then we can start to heat up that nut area in here. Okay, and there is this nut. It is in that one. What is this hardest nut ever in my life? And now I need to open that nut, and let's go to look at how it happens. Okay, and now I start to heat up this nut using my torch, and I install in also in here this feel that I can then open also this nut. And let's go to look at how I manage to open that nut. Let's look my heat up process next. Okay, and there is this my nut, and I have in here also this temperature meter, what measures these temperatures. And now when I check this nut's heat, it is like 47 Fahrenheit just now. 47 is this amount in here. And now we can even see 47 is this our starting point. And let's look even closer. We can check all time that what is this my nut's temperature, and now we can see that nut is now 46 Fahrenheit. It is about in Celsius something like 15 Celsius, or sorry, 7 Celsius, 45 Fahrenheit in here. And there we can see this red dot, and it sends this information that now temperature is 47. And then I take my torch, and I start to heat up this area. And firstly I start that. And in that area I focus this my flame. Now we can take sample, and now there is even this 300 Fahrenheit in there, and now it is 385, and now I continue this my heat up, okay, and now this my torch is heating that, and we can check these heat numbers, and there is 300, now there is 600 Fahrenheit, this temperature in there. Fahrenheit in this nut's temperature. Now there is 644. And let's look closer. And now we can see how this heat works. My nut is there like heating, and this can take like 5 minutes. to this heat up. Okay, and then I stop this heating, and now we check these temperatures. Now this my steel, this bolt is 330 Fahrenheit. This my nut, and then this central area is 200. And now I need also this ice from freezer. And now I install this ice in the central area. And now I start to do the central area cooler than this nut. Now I install this my ice only in this that central nut area. And central this bolt area, and this nut is like hotter. Now I cool down that area. Now I am cool downing this inner bolt, and I try to cool down, and then I install my socket in here. And let's look that can I open now this nut. Let's look. Okay, and now when I have heat up that about 20 minutes, I install this my socket in here, and then I do my thing that I heat now this my wrench. And now I am planning to use this my rubber hammer, and I heat that in here like hard heat. And I believe that now this nut opens, and let's look that when I install this my long bar, that what happens. Okay, and now install this my long metallic bar in here, and then let's look that what happens next. Okay, yes, and now this 1000 newton meters nut opens. Excellent. Excellent. Now it is moving, and I can use my hand. Not yet hands, but now this nut is open, and I rotate that little bit more, and we can soon see that what this nut looks like. Very hard job. Okay, and now when I have worked in here a couple of minutes, now I can use this my standard bar, and I can open these nuts in that way. This runs so nicely, and then I have also installed, I have in here this lubricant oil. And I have installed this stuff in there quite a lot. And now I can use this my electric impact driver. And let's look at how I open. Okay, good. And there is then this nut. It is in there inside. Really cool. And now we can look that nut soon closer. Okay, and there we can see this 1000 newton meters nut. And when we look in that down area, it looks quite okay, only that it is so totally stuck. Very difficult bolt to open. And there is this my socket, and socket is okay, no any issues. But now this bolt is free, and we can think that how we can open bolt and nut, what is so hard to open that we need 1000 newton meters force. And finally this job is done. And thank you, my friend, for watching.